Go and investigate, just don't go far. Go and investigate, it's okay. Don't you think it's beautiful? Oh no! That's a window, but it's all blocked up. What about in that window there? No, why don't we go and ask one of the people at the desk what's in there? Yeah, go ask. Say, excuse me.
How about more?
No, if you want to know, you ask. Ah, well. Then that, you'll just have to go without knowing then, won't you?
Are you okay? Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Wow. Dorothy, what were you going to do? Dorothy, can you do it again? Do it again so Goofy can see. Oh, wonderful. Was that great fun? And he was waving at you with them.
When Mickey comes round.
Oh, look. Mickey kisses and say thank you. Wow. Oh wow, what could they say to Donald? Yeah? Oh. Gonna blow kisses. kisses. Oh.
Big hug.
Oh, he wants a kiss on his nose. Oh, you've made him go all shy. Oh, he's going to save the kiss. Say bye-bye, Donald. We love you. He's saving your kisses.
We're going to Rafiki.
Some things are just too beautiful, really. I think it might be.
Can I go?
Yes, we will. So whenever we see any of those symbols, we need to stop, okay?
Expedition Everest team members should proceed to the loading platform. Once on board, please take your seat immediately, pull down the restraint, and secure all gear in the cargo bag in front of you.
I don't quite know how I feel. Trip.
I've been looking forward to this ride for about a year.
Well, I have just been on that. And actually it was awesome, really, really good fun. Scary, but not imagine all the horrific ways you might die scary. So Flick's gone straight back on, she's gone on the single rider thing, so she's just whizzing around again straight away. And I'm gonna go off and meet the rest of the gang, but I really enjoyed it. I'd do it again, actually, in a heartbeat. Yay me, I'm not as old as I thought I was. Hey.
Everybody's
going to jump. Everybody mining
is
almost up. Now we are
safari
diver today
through the
Harambe
Wildlife Reserve. Over here on the left hand side, you're
going to
see a hippo swimming and a group of hippos is known as a
bloat. Do you see? Oh. Are they here? Yeah, they are, darling.
Going to
get lots of
people. And you know, it's known as wee honking, and you can hear that from up to 2 miles away. You can also see those birds over here on our left, and they're the pink-backed pelican, getting their name because during mating season, their feathers turn a shade of pink. But they are colonial nesting birds, meaning that you can typically find those birds nesting within large flocks. That baobab tree is known as the upside-down tree, and that is because 9 months out of the year, it does go leafless. So the branches of that tree resemble roots. But it's a great place for water storage, and that is because that tree absorbs the water during the rainy season. So during the dry season, animals such as the elephant can use their tusks to cage into there to gain some of that water resource. They can grow up to around 75 feet tall and be around 1,000 years old. It's the Patterson's eland. That eland can jump up to 8 feet from a standstill position. The male can weigh around 2,000 pounds. You'll see these animals crossing right in front of me. And they are the springbok. And on either side of us, you're going to see these black and gray animals, which are the white bearded
ones. Oh, look at them jumping!
Look at those springboks cronking. Determine that from their irregular song pattern.
Look over there, there's one baby giraffe and a mummy giraffe.
A baby and a mummy.
18 hours a day.
Wow.
We only sleep 30 minutes a day. Those 30
I don't know anything about giraffe poop, darling. You're the poop expert.
But giraffes have 7 neck vertebrae, and that is the same.
They might, yes, well, that's true. They're being safe, aren't they?
Country, they can determine that because you're going to see how this bridge has seen better days in the past. Also notice how that tree trunk on that right hand side has been knocked down by the great force of
the elements. Oh, that was a
creaky
bridge.
Yeah,
that was
the elephants do not like the noise that bees make. So farmers in Africa have placed beehives around their crops to keep elephants away from stampeding over them. And that is because it does act as a natural barrier.
I think there is a baby one, darling.
Yeah, a tree of
life.
Good boy.
That's the one. A baby.
Wow.
That one.
That's the daddy,
yeah.
Yeah,
good boy.
He's clapping
it. The bingo, is it?
That's good. That's a mess. Cut down for a minute.
And look up. We'll see if we can stop over here for just a moment or so, because you'll see the ostrich.
Where's the dog?
The ostrich do not fly, but they can run up to run.
You guys need a hiya!
Did you enjoy watching?
No.
No, okay.
Where's an angle? And it's behind you.
You said you didn't have any alcohol in the house.
No, we have no alcohol in the house.
You can't seem to hold that camera straight.
That's tiredness. We've escaped. We've left the short people with the big people.
You must press the button.
Oh, yeah. Pressing the button works, doesn't it? Or we can just stand in the lift. That would be our night out. We'll just stand in the lift for hours on end. It's not actually that funny. We could conceivably do that.
I'm going to see if I see as well.
So the question is, what do you do with your time when your teenagers are looking after your small children?
Something exciting.
And you're knackered. But
something
you want to go out with, yeah, something really exciting. You want to go out with tonight. What do you do? You're on holiday in this beautiful, amazing country with all the most famous theme parks in the world on your doorstep, and You've got no children with you. And
something exciting.
I know, and the weather's amazing, and I can't wait. Where are we going, Paul?
Walmart.
Welcome to the real world. Where people go to Walmart.
We're going to take the tank though.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, well, Paul's excited because he's taking this bizarrely big vehicle thing with him. Oh, even the air conditioning's hot.
Yeah. Max AC.
So, yes, we are actually, literally, technically, not theoretically, realistically, completely and utterly going to Walmart with our night off. Is anyone going to be able to hear any of this because of the aircon?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
We could just lip sync over something else over the top of it so it sounds as though we're not going to Walmart.
I don't care. I'm looking forward to my date at Walmart. We need to get some more food. More importantly, we need to get some more wine. More alcohol. We've had a great day, I think, as you've seen. We've done the jungly safari expedition-y thingy, which was good fun. Bought the kids more random toys. Do you know what? I have decided, though, that there is one major, and this is genuine, complaint about holidays, so particularly coming somewhere like this, you meet so many lovely people. I've had several conversations over the last two or three days with some really, really lovely people, and you just think, oh, I really like you, and then you go, and they go,
and never to be seen again. And that really makes me sad. All these people that want to put me in my pocket and take them home with me. And we met this lovely, two lovely couples on the bus today. They were travelling together. So, Jonas and Jessica, and Justin and Lindsay. And they were just so friendly and approachable, and they were chatting to the kids, and they were really interested, and they were interesting, and I keep thinking, oh, I wish I'd asked that, I wish I knew that. And we're talking, what, a 15-minute bus journey?
Yeah.
And then you just say bye, and you're never gonna see these people again, and I hate that.
Trying to turn the thing for a speed down.
He's fiddling. Done. So anyway, he's still fiddling. I mean, it's better than the fact that in the UK no one ever has any kind of conversation with anybody in public other than perhaps a grunt or a moan or a whinge. So obviously it's a significantly better way of living. But it kind of makes me sad. So, I don't know. Anyway, shake it off. Shake it off. We are going to Walmart to stock up on healthy Booze. Snacks. And yeah, there was a chance we would go out again, but I don't suppose for a minute we will, but we'll see. You can't just leave your food in the car like you can at home, because it would be a big puddle of meh if we did that.
Yeah.
So Paul has turned on the seat air conditioning. Which I am actually now beginning to feel. It's a really bizarre feeling, because my bottom is just getting very gently chilly. Where are you? You're straddling the line.
No, I'm just going across the exit off the next. Not this one.
I can't quite work out whether I like this. It's like, it's very weird. I just did this whole really witty thing to camera and it wasn't even recording.
This app's language does not match the active language of Siri. Commands may not work as expected.
There you go.
We've done Walmart. We've got a Subway for dinner. Because you get Subways inside supermarkets, apparently. We have purchased an obscene amount of highly sugared produce that's not even real food. And a big bottle of booze. And I am broken. I am so tired. We've got a late start tomorrow and we need it. Pool morning. Mm-hmm. Pool morning, not Paul morning. Pool. Anyway, I'm gonna go now. Go home, eat Subway, drink alcohol, eat high sugared foods. Yep. Florida, you've broken me. Good night.
Thanks.